Hello, kia ora. Time for your Bachelorette New Zealand recap. I'm Mama C. It's going to be a no-frills recap because I got lots going on. So, let's get on with it. Last time, McDreamy got lots of alone time with Lucina. They were setting us up for an Aaron or Jesse eviction from the house. Who are they going to be sending home tonight? Well, we start off with the rose ceremony. Everybody's nervous. Lucina has given out no pre-ceremony roses, so all her blokes are a bit worried. Ladies talk about what a great day they had doing the polo, and then it's time. Lucina picks Mike, no surprises there. Lily then picks Quinn. Now remember, she had already given a rose to Richie on their date, so he's already covered. Lucina then chooses Logan. Then Lucina gets to pick another one, and that goes to Michael, which was a bit of a shocker because he still has not had an actual date with her. Lily then picks Terrence. Lucina then is ready to give out the last rose and is looking all stern. And then an ad break, of course, and when we come back, she finally says Aaron. I was like, oh, thank goodness. All right, so then Lily then has Lily's last rose then goes to, well, all that's left is Elliot and Jesse. And then she says, Jesse. Well, I was a bit gutted because Elliot is so much fun and he always kept things upbeat and the other boys were making drama. And in true form, he jokes his way out and he says he reckons he could have rocked her world. Lily says, you know, she didn't want to have to let him go. And then he jokes, of course, well, then why did you? they all have a good chuckle. The boys sing him out. Yeah, I'm going to miss Elliot. He was a lot of fun. So it was nice that he was able to come back and show his fun side. All right, so the next day we hear Michael, he's venting his frustrations, you know, because he's done group dates, he's had a couple of one-on-ones, but no real date. He's keen to get to know Lucina better, and he wants a little respect. He is so close to packing and leaving. He's sharing this with McDreamy and Richie. McDreamy gets why Michael is bumming, and, you know, he wants him to have his chance. However, he does really enjoy having his time with Lucina. Single dates day. Logan is going on a single date with Lucina today, and Jesse is going on a date with Lily. I let the other lads know, and Michael is, you know, getting more upset. Off they go to meet the girls, and there are horses. It's a gaucho experience, which is like a Spanish cowboy. Mind you, this would have been the perfect date for Michael, but nope, he didn't get his shot. Lily and Jesse chat about kissing at cocktail parties, you know, and other random stuff. Logan is a bit nervous. Jesse jumps right on the horse. They have to do this joust thing with this tiny little ring thing. Jesse ended up doing it. Logan had his turn. He says he feels he has a better chance of falling off his horse than hitting the target. Logan is basically just bouncing around on his horse. Lucina's having a good laugh. The girls then have a shot at throwing a spear while riding their horses. Then they get to stand on their horses. Then they all lay down on the ground with their horses and have a bit of a cuddle with them. Yeah, it was pretty cool. Then they do like a heap of riding, which was kind of cool. Meanwhile, back at the house, Michael is making some jokes to cope with his sort of house arrest in a way. Lily and Jesse have their time alone. She tells us that their relationship is like frenzy. You know, it's not really romantic. She says, that she's hoping to see if there can be anything more to it because they end up joking around a lot. Then they try to climb into a hammock and then they just both fall out splat on the ground. So they opt for benches. Lily wants things to be more natural and easy with him. She doesn't want to force it. She doesn't want to press him with a bunch of questions, but she says they need to get to know each other more. She asks him how does he feel about her at this point. And of course, they go to an ad break. When they come back, he says, you know, the best partner for him would be like be his best friend first. And, you know, he says she's fun and makes him weak in the knees. And he says he feels good but nervous. He's afraid of getting hurt, obviously. He says she is worth the risk. Lily then offers Jesse a rose and he accepts. And then they kiss with lots of Lily's tongue. Logan and Lucina rehash Logan's horse abilities. They have a bit of a laugh. Lucina says others have said he seems cocky because of his confidence. But I don't really see that, but then we don't see everything either. I mean, he's goofy and fun. She asks where does his confidence come from? And he says, well, because he knows what he brings to the table. You know, he's traveled the world. You know, he says, you know, he does have a sexy side, but he does have a dorky side as well. You know, that sort of thing. Logan cozies up to Lucina and goes in for the kiss. They give us a rundown of his kissing abilities. Lucina says his kissing is improving, but still needs work. She asks him how he feels about her, and he tells us he wasn't sure he could fall in love again. And she's given him hope, and they have a few more kisses. He says he has put himself out there a little more, so, you know, he's feeling positive. Next morning, Lily says they are going fishing. It's a group date. Aaron isn't included in the group date. Then they show Jesse, you know, that whole flashback of his dark side and how he's just been so nasty to Aaron and all that kind of stuff, as if we needed to rehash that, but they like to keep showing it to us. So the group then heads to some boats. They get ready to go out fishing. McDreamy asks what the prize is. He says a rose. Lucina says they can have, whoever catches the first fish can have what they want, but not a rose. Of course, you know, he then hooks something as if on cue. Can he bring it in? Well, of course he can. So he pulls it in, and Lucina is the only one applauding this. Because I don't think any of the guys were real thrilled about that whole situation. So now he has to decide what he wants as he drops his fish back into the water. Meanwhile, Jesse and Aaron are left there. They wanted to see if something would happen between them. You know, they play more footage of the stupidity of all the other crap. You know, the reasons for why the boys treat Aaron like crap. The other lads have no luck in the fishing department. Michael wants his time. Quinn wants his time. Lily says they caught some memories, but that was pretty much it. She said they were all pretty garbage, so she says she ends up picking Quinn since she hasn't seen as much of him lately. Yay, we like Quinn. So Lucina picks Mike again, even though, you know, Michael still hasn't had his date. Michael is as confused as the rest of us. Right? Yeah, I know. It's like, what is she doing? What is this game she's playing with him? So Lily and Quinn, they share some beersies, and Chad, he says he loves spending as much time as he can with her, and he asks, what is she looking for? She says honesty, and she wonders if he isn't ready to show more of himself. She asks how he'd feel to be in her top three, and he says he would be rapt because, you know, he wants to take her to see his family and, you know, show what his life is like, you know, on the outside. And it would mean the absolute world to him. And then, you know, they go in for the pash. Lucina and Mike talk about relationships. He says this is pretty scary and he had shut out a lot of his emotions. And, you know, now it's like huge, you know. But it's like a crash course in, you know, just getting through things and opening up and all that sort of thing. And he says, you know, you can't avoid the hard questions. But now they both seem to say it's going at a good pace. At least Lucina feels it is. And then he brings up the wager. And he says, I can have whatever I want, right? And she says, except a rose. And he says, I want. Well, then after the commercial break, as they do, they come back. And he says, one-on-one time later tonight. Now, you know this is going to grind some people's gears. You know it. Because he's had heaps of time with her. So Lucina then says there is a lot of sexual chemistry between them. She says he isn't as physical as she likes, but then, you know, he drags her behind a building and passes, you know, they get pashing. I mean, obviously he doesn't want to make out on camera. That's my guess. So then we flash to Art and the girls prepping for the cocktail party, then off to the party. Lily joins her four blokes. She's proud that they are there for her. Lucina joins her four blokes. Aaron feels that Michael is kind of hard done by. You know, he's been there like 2 weeks and he still has had no date at all. She asks her guys what is that they bring to the table. Mike says honesty. Logan says making a relationship with her family. You know, he would go the extra mile to do that. Aaron says he brings energy, excitement, and honesty. Lucina pulls Mike aside for his winning fish catch one-on-one time. And Aaron questions why Mike needs so much more time with her. He gets time with her all the time. Michael and Logan say he does get a lot of time. I mean, it's obvious. Everybody notices it. Aaron says it's going to be time to swoop in soon. Mm-hmm. Lucina and McDreamy say they both want to have more time together. He says he doesn't like irrational people because they're talking about different things. She asks how they would resolve arguments. He says in the past he used to walk away and sort of ignore them, but he says now he reckons that you should just get it all on the table and resolve it, because that's the best way to deal with it, is just head on. Mike says Lucina seems almost hesitant and asks why that is. What is she afraid of? He asks, is there a connection? She says yes. Is she hesitant? Yes. And more so with him than any other guy. And I think that's probably because of all the sexual chemistry. That's just my thought process on there. She says it almost seems like they're in a sparring situation because, like, you know, they ask each other the questions, but it's like, I think he just doesn't want to feel like he's being grilled on television. That's my guess, but yeah. He says he feels he's given a lot, and, you know, she says it has been a bit scary. He says, "You asked me today, am I ready?" And he says, "But are you?" Which is a very good question, because she tends to avoid all answering all these questions, doesn't she? So, of course, then we go off to Lily and Terrence. They're having a little chat. Terrence has a gift for Lily that he got an artist to do near their place that they were staying at in the city. And there was a nice story behind it and everything. It was pretty cool. And it's a rose. So he says, "This is my rose for you." She kisses him and they hug, and she's really appreciative of his gift. And he confesses that she is the first person that he has really opened up to. She feels great, but, you know, is a bit worried about that. But, you know, that's a huge step for him. So, I mean, that's big for Terrence, you know? That's really big for him. Well, anyway, they end up telling us again that, you know, the next rose ceremony is going to be the biggest one yet. You know, they infer that someone is ready to leave. Is it Michael? Has he finally, you know, hit his breaking point and ready to just get out of there? Because he has talked about it. Or is it going to be Aaron? Because, again, they show Aaron, you know, starting to ask questions like to Lucina, you know, why did she want to do a television show and things like that. So I guess we will find that out. So join us again tomorrow night for another Bachelorette New Zealand recap. I'm Mama C. Have a great day wherever you are.